Oh my God, it's...
What's up, people of the internet? My name is Hondro, and I'm back with another episode of Power Up or Pokedex Only, a detailed look into a Pokemon's stats, typing, strengths, and weaknesses that we will use to determine if it's a worthwhile investment of candy and Stardust, or if you should just keep it as a trophy for your Pokedex. In today's episode, we'll explore the epitome of elegance and grace that is Gardevoir. Gardevoir becomes more and more sleek as she evolves. She starts out just as little Ralts, so cute. Then she hits puberty and evolves into Kirlia. Then finally, she blossoms into Gardevoir, a proverbial psychic and fairy queen. Now, here's an important disclaimer. Ralts has two possible final forms, depending on gender. Right now, in Pokemon Go, you can evolve both female and male Ralts all the way to Gardevoir. I would save any good male Ralts that you have for Gen 4 when you can evolve them into Gallade. Only male Ralts and Kirlias can evolve into Gallade. So if you want a Gardevoir right now, I strongly suggest evolving females only. Now, with that disclaimer out of the way, let's get back to it. Going from Ralts to Gardevoir will set you back 125 candies, which is actually a good indication of Gardevoir's worth. With that in mind, let's jump right into her battle prowess by looking at her typing weaknesses and personal moveset strengths. Gardevoir is both psychic and fairy type, and that lends her to have a 1.5 times weakness to steel, ghost, and poison attacks. So when going up against gym defenders or raid bosses with those types of attacks, such as Aggron and Gengar, avoid using Gardevoir. Her dual typing also provides her with some seriously powerful resistances. She has a single resistance to psychic attacks, and a double resistance to both dragon and fighting moves. These make her an amazing gym defender, especially if she's defending alongside Pokemon like Blissey and Snorlax, who both have fighting weaknesses. She breaks up that team and doesn't allow fighting Pokemon to sweep the gym. As far as her movesets go, you can build Gardevoir in a few different ways. She has two quick attack options, Confusion, a psychic attack, and Charge Beam, an electric move. Charge Beam is faster and fills your charge attack meter quickly, but Confusion hits harder and has the benefit of hitting meta fighting types super effectively. She also has three different charge moves, Psychic, obviously a psychic attack, Dazzling Gleam, a fairy move, and Shadow Ball, a ghost attack. Psychic pairs nicely with Confusion for a double psychic combo. But ever since Niantic changed Psychic to a single bar attack, its DPS has gone down significantly. Dazzling Gleam is Gardevoir's powerhouse move, her highest DPS by far, and it's super effective against fighting, dragon, and dark types, so it smashes commonly used attackers such as Machamp, Tyranitar, and all of the dragons. Shadow Ball is a powerful ghost move, but it isn't super useful in the current meta, and doesn't pair well with Gardevoir's typing. My moveset of choice here is Confusion and Dazzling Gleam. It makes her an outstanding gym defender and a powerful attacker, especially against all of the new dragons that people will be dropping onto gyms after this Dratini event. Now let's take a look at Gardevoir's base stats and see how she stacks up against some other Pokemon in her typing groups. Gardevoir has a base attack of 237, defense of 220, stamina of 136, and a max CP of 2964. Very solid stats. So let's compare to some of the best current psychic types in the game. We'll start with Alakazam. 271 attack, 194 defense, 110 stamina, and a max CP of 2887. Alakazam has more raw power, but is much more of a glass cannon when it comes to defense and HP. Next, let's look at Espeon. 261 attack, 194 defense, 130 stamina, and a max CP of 3000. Espeon is a close psychic-only equivalent to Gardevoir, but its single typing and ability to only learn psychic moves prevents it from being quite as versatile. Finally, let's compare it to Mewtwo, the psychic powerhouse. 300 attack, 182 defense, 193 stamina, and a max CP of 3982. Mewtwo has the highest attack stat for any Psychic-type Pokemon, and overall would be even better if not for its 9% stat nerf. But it can't be used as a gym defender, so its usefulness is as an attacker only. Now that we have a good idea of how Gardevoir compares with other psychic types, let's see how she matches up against some of her fairy counterparts. First up, Wigglytuff. 156 attack, 93 defense, 280 stamina, and a max CP of 1906. Good HP, but pretty worthless otherwise. Next up, Clefable, with 178 attack, 171 defense, 190 stamina, and a max CP of 2353. Clefable is a surprisingly well-rounded Pokemon that can be strong in specialty situations. Finally, we'll compare to Granbull. 212 attack, 137 defense, 180 stamina, and a max CP of 2440. Granbull is no slouch in the fairy department, but it's no match for the raw power and defenses of Gardevoir. So it turns out that Gardevoir is a seriously impressive and versatile Pokemon. She's a great attacker and defender, especially against fighting and dragon types. She is super effective against them and resistant to their attacks at the same time. That's awesome. With all of the new dragons like Salamence and Rayquaza, she only becomes better and more useful. On top of all of this, she mega evolves later on and becomes even more powerful. Her attack stat goes up tremendously and her defenses improve as well. She will be crazy strong then, but mega forms are a long way off, so we'll just have to wait. My recommendation for Gardevoir is an easy one. Power up. She is far too useful to not have one in your arsenal. I recommend having at least two powered up. One you can spare as a gym defender if you want, and one as your mainstay specialized attacker for shredding gyms. She is a perfect use of candy and stardust, and a great investment going forward as well. And that's my verdict, but tell me your thoughts on Gardevoir. Are you still saving up for one? Is she your favorite Pokemon? Are you excited for her mega form? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed or learned something useful, hit that thumbs up button and consider subscribing to my channel for more content like this. Also, be sure to ring that bell icon so that you can be notified as soon as my videos go live. Check me out on other social networks, links are in the description. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm Loco Hondro, and I'll see you later. Peace, Poke Trainers!